मॉर्निंग माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ई लर्निंग क्लास ऑफ इंग्लिश ऑफ क्लास 3. टूडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू न्यू चैप्टर, चैप्टर 8, ए ट्रिप टू मार्स. इन दिस चैप्टर यू विल कम टू नो अबाउट एस्ट्रोनेट एंड प्लैनेट मार्स. चिल्ड्रेन, यू मस्ट बी अवेयर दैट वी आर लिविंग इन ए प्लैनेट अर्थ. इन दिस स्टोरी वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी टू द प्लैनेट मार्स. And that was the introduction of the story. Let's start first paragraph. Captain Gina had gone into outer space several times in a spacecraft with other astronauts and scientists. But this time it was different. This time she was going to fly a spacecraft to Mars alone. She wanted to explore it and see and know a lot of different things about the planet. She also wanted to collect rocks and soil from there and bring them back to Earth for the scientists to study them. After a lot of discussion with other astronauts and scientists, Captain Gina set off on her journey to Mars a few days later. Several times Captain Gina had gone along with other astronauts and scientists, but this time it was different. She was going to travel to Mars, and that too all alone. Nobody is going to a company. She wanted to explore about different things about the planet, and she also wanted to collect different kinds of rocks and soil. From there she wanted to bring to the planet Earth where she was living. She wanted to bring for other scientists to study about the planet Mars. After a lot of discussion, she started the journey to planet Mars. Next paragraph. A small robot called Curio accompanied her on her trip to help her on Mars. As she moved further into space, Captain Gina watched the Earth getting smaller and smaller. She noticed the stars in the sky and thought about the planets that go around the sun. And along with her went a small robot called Curio, and that robot helped her in reaching the planet Mars. Now, as she moved into the space, she watched the Earth getting smaller and smaller. She could see the Earth in smaller size. She even noticed the beautiful stars in the sky. They were twinkling, and she started thinking about the planets that go around the sun. Next paragraph. After many days, the spacecraft finally reached Mars. It took a long time for them to reach Mars since it was so far from Earth. In this paragraph, after traveling many days, spacecraft reached the planet Mars, and it took lots of time to reach to the planet Mars because it was very far from Earth. Let us move to the next page. Oh wow, I can see the two moons of Mars, Captain Gina said eagerly to herself. She then landed the spacecraft on the planet's surface. As she looked out of the window, she became very excited about finally reaching Mars. She couldn't wait to start her work. Let me take my digging tools with me, she said. Then she opened the hut door and got down from the spacecraft. In this paragraph, when she reached near Mars, she could see the two moons of Mars. So she was very happy to see that two moons of Mars. And Captain Gina was very happy that finally she has reached Mars. And when she looked out of the window, she was very excited that she had finally landed on Mars, and she couldn't wait for her work to start. And she started her work. She started digging tools and she opened the hush door. Hush door is a special kind of door found in ships in spacecraft to come out from the spacecraft. Next paragraph. Captain Gina wore a special spacesuit which she had brought along with her. She also carried an air tank on her back to help her breathe, as she did not want to breathe the dangerous air on Mars. She looked at the surface of the planet and decided to walk far away from the spacecraft in search of rocks and soil. Mars is full of large and rocky hills, she said. In this paragraph, Captain Gina wore a special spacesuit which she had brought along with her, and she carried an air tank at her back to breathe because she did not want to breathe the dangerous air on Mars. She looked at the surface of Mars and decided to walk ahead from the spacecraft in the search of rocks and soil. And then she said that Mars is full of rocks. Next paragraph. Captain Gina's scientist friends had already told her about all the good places on Mars from where she could dig out the rocks. Now, I should go in search of the spots from where I can find the right rocks for the test, she said. Curio too went along with her to help her find the rocks. In this paragraph, Captain Gina said that her scientist friends had already told her about the good places where she could get rocks to get ready in search of good soil so she could carry it to planet Earth for the other scientist study. Planet Mars. Now, this robot Curio also went to help her. Next paragraph. The scientists had asked Gina to collect rocks and soil from the surface of Mars because they wanted to see if there was life on Mars long ago. Captain Gina used her digging tool and collected a lot of rocks to perform tests on them. She then took the help of Curio to study the rocks and see if they could be taken back to the scientists on Earth. Now here, she started looking for rocks so that she could carry it to the Earth because her scientist friends, they wanted to see that Mars has life or not. They could study seeing the rocks. Next paragraph. Curio helped Captain Gina study the rocks. It also assisted her in digging a few more rocks from the soil. Finally, it took a picture of Captain Gina and sent it to Earth for the other astronauts and scientists to see. Finally, Curio took the picture of Captain Gina and sent it to Earth for all the other astronauts and scientists to see. Next paragraph. At last, the time came for Captain Gina and Curio to leave the red planet and head back home. They traveled past all the planets and stars. Captain Gina's work was done as she had brought back all the rocks which she had collected on her mission. At last, finally, the time came them to leave the red planet Mars and return back to home. Now they traveled almost all the planets and stars. Now Captain Gina's work was done and she was very happy, and she brought back all the rocks which she had collected for her. Last paragraph. She came back and told everyone about what she saw on Mars. The scientists thought that people had lived on Mars a long times ago. They even wondered if Mars was green and blue like Earth at one time. All the scientists congratulated Captain Gina and told her what excellent work she had done. "Well done, Captain Gina. Soon it will be time for you to get ready for another trip," they said together. Now here, she came back and told everyone about different things, whatever she had seen on Mars, to the other scientist friend who lives on Earth. They even thought that people used to live on that Mars. They thought that if Mars was green and blue in color like Earth, all the scientists congratulated Captain Gina and they even said she had done a wonderful job. All the scientists told her that, "Well done, Captain Gina. You had done a good job and please you get ready for the another trip. We will sending you for another trip." Students, I hope that you all understood this chapter. Thank you.